안녕하세요. 빅샷 인터뷰 김민지입니다. 오늘은 최근 이야기 많이 나오고 있는 중국 시장에 집중해 볼까 하는데요. 베어릭의 주식 투자 담당이사 윌리엄 퐁과 이 시간 함께 하시겠습니다.
Hello.
Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
First, I'd like to ask you about the fundamental aspect of China. Mm-hmm. How do you evaluate the economic situation mm-hmm. in China?
Mm-hmm. I think in the last few months, if you look at the economic data in China, we actually saw some weakness. Even though the Chinese government has already started the monetary easing by cutting interest rates and cutting the triple R ratio, we continue to see some downward pressure in the economy. But the good thing is in the last 1 month, we have seen some recovery, particularly in the consumer sentiment area and also in the property sales. So we actually expect that going forward in the coming few months, there should be more area which should see some economic recovery.
Okay, but still some say that the fundamentals do not support the rally. What do you think about that?
I think this is always a concern about the Chinese market has gone up a lot, particularly the Shanghai market, while the underlying economic growth is not there. But my thinking is that actually if you look at the other examples in other countries, for example, in US or Europe, when they first announced the monetary easing, the stock market will react very positively. I think that is the situation that the stock market is always react far ahead of the economic recovery. If an investor really decide to wait until the signal, he or she may be too late in capture this rebound.
Then I'd like to ask you, is the A-share, the Shanghai Index, mm-hmm. overvalued in your point of view?
I must say that if you look at the overall index level of the China A-share market, it is not too bad, even though it is more expensive than last year. But if you compare the Shanghai market versus the last bubble in 2007, valuation is still very low compared to that level. But what we are concerned is in certain areas, particularly some small cap companies, for example, some technology company listing in Shenzhen or Shanghai, the valuation is seems to me is a little bit too high.
So what do you think about the Hong Kong A-share? Because people were actually concerning about the A-share a lot, but these days they are actually having an interest in the Hong Kong market.
I think Hong Kong market has been lagging behind its Asia counterparts in the last 1 year. And if you look at the valuation of many Chinese companies listing in Hong Kong, their valuation are actually quite attractive. So in my view, there is a chance for the Hong Kong market, particularly the Chinese stock, to catch up, to go up further, so as to narrow down the gap between the Asia and the H share. But I think the Hong Kong market is dominated by the institutional investors. So most of the institutional investor will prefer to wait until they see some kind of earning growth or earning recovery. In my opinion, I think we should be able to see some earning recovery going towards the end of this year. So by that time, maybe the interest into the Chinese company listing in Hong Kong will be increased again.
Okay, is there special sectors that you've been looking at recently?
For us, we invest in the sector or company which can deliver very long-term sustainable growth, which is also in line with the government's policy to promote a more sustainable growth. If we look at those sectors which will benefit from this trend, mostly the domestic sector, for example, like some consumer discretionary company and even some information technology companies. Because those companies, not only they are supported by this government policy, but in terms of the fundamental growth, those sector or those companies will have very good fundamental growth in the long run.
Okay, you've mentioned about the stimulus, so China has recently introduced a series of measures, including rate cuts. So do you expect more stimulus and do you think there is need for more?
I think the market is still looking for one or two interest rate cuts for the remaining of this year and also some triple R cuts. I think in my opinion, the inflation pressure in China is still very low. And even the property price used to be a big headache for Chinese government and is still under control in the moment. So I think the Chinese government will definitely has more room or more flexibility to do the stimulus if they want to.
Next is MSCI issue. Asia was not included. How would this affect the Chinese and Korean market?
Actually, I'm not too concerned about the actual timing of whether it is included or not. And as we know, MSCI, they have issued some concern about the quota system and also the convertibility of the currency, so which may make this inclusion a bit late. But if we look at the big picture, the open up of the Chinese capital market is an ongoing trend, and this inclusion of the MSCI Asia into the world index is eventually, I think it will happen. And in my opinion, I think MSCI will start to reevaluate the possibility of inclusion of China A share into their index. I don't think we need to wait for a long time for them to consider it.
Okay, when do you expect?
I think by end of this year, mm-hmm. MSCI may start to evaluate again. If it is not the case, then anytime next year, they can do so.
Foreign investors often compare the Taiwanese market with the Korean market. Mm-hmm. So what do you think about these two markets?
Mm-hmm. Yes, actually, from our standpoint, Korean market and Taiwanese market are more the export driven. And both of the economy are more rely on the country that they export to, that means the US. And I think the major difference between the two markets is, I think in terms of the manufacturing industry, and Korean and Taiwan, they are basically specialized in two different areas. In Korea, we can see more brands, more domestic brand, more consumption companies, but in Taiwan it's more about technology and semiconductor. And one more difference is that the Korean market may face more head-on competition with Japanese, mm-hmm. Japanese manufacturers, where Taiwanese manufacturer may face more competition with Chinese. So if I'm allowed to choose, I will pick one or two companies in each of the exchange.
Okay, this would be my last question. Mm-hmm. Do you have any investment tips to our viewers?
For Korean business news viewers, I think to invest in China, you still need to be a bit selective, and then to pick the right company. Because even though I'm actually quite positive in the Chinese company listing in Hong Kong this year, but I think there, as an investor, you still need to differentiate between a good company and a bad company. So I think my only suggestion is be selective.
Okay, thank you for today.
Thank you.
네, 윌리엄 퐁 이사와 오늘 함께 하셨습니다. 중국 시장에 대해 가지셨던 많은 궁금증들 해소되셨으면 좋겠습니다. 시청해주셔서 고맙습니다.